What is up, my kin? My name is Kin Ping, but you can call me Kin, and I'm here with another tier list video. You guys have heard me say that a lot, but I'm here with another tier list video, and this time we're talking about Mortal Kombat, and we're not talking about guest characters anymore. Thank God. That guest character tier list took ages to record. We're here talking about some actual characters from Mortal Kombat now, and their skins, their Kombat League skins to be precise. So here, I have all the Kombat League skins from all the different seasons, all in order actually. Disclaimer, I did not make this. This wonderful person here did. Thank you so much. This fits with my OCD perfectly, how it's all, you know, season 1, season 2, season 3, and they're all good pictures as well, so thank you so much for that. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to doing this tier list because there are some awesome suits or skins. And to the side here, I do have some larger pictures of all the skins, so I got a closer view, better look, because I don't know all of these off by heart, don't know what they all look like. So I've got some pictures here, so if you ever hear me lean off to this side, I'm looking at the pictures a bit closer. Obviously, as I go through and rank all of these, I will have some pictures appear on the side like I have for my Wonder Woman one and my Damian Wayne one, so you guys get a better look at them as well. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this. Tier lists are really becoming my thing at the moment. I am kind of planning to add some more gameplay into my YouTube channel, but tier lists seem to be doing well. And these are all really cool suits. So even if you don't really know Mortal Kombat, you can look at these suits and, you know, go, oh, that looks really cool. And, you know, ranking them. Because you don't need to know about the characters to rank them. Yeah, man. So I think we should just get it started. So, the first one here is Scorpion. And it is the Season of Blood. So the first Kombat League season is the Season of Blood. And here we have Scorpion, Scarlet, Aaron Black, and Katana. Four pretty cool characters. I think Scorpion, maybe Katana is my least favorite out of all of these. But red aesthetic, blood aesthetic, what could go wrong? The only problem with these as a like overall is that they don't really look very different. So we're going to be ranking Scorpion here. And his costume, it just doesn't look any different from like his normal stuff. Like it literally does not. It's just the colors. It's just giving him like fancy shiny red and black. Other than that, it's actually not that different, and so it's a bit of a bummer, to be completely honest. It's not doing anything different. The costume itself is just kind of, but there is an alternate color. There's an alternate color where instead of the black there's white, which I should show another picture here for you guys showing the alternate sort of color variations of the different skins. So I do like that one. I think that one looks really nice. But just the simple fact that there's actually not much changed of the costume, it's kind of just the colors, I think that automatically gives it a bad. But because it's got cool colors, I don't think it deserves a horrible. I think I'm going to put it in bad because it's just a recoloring. There's not actually anything new there, really. I mean, there probably is, but it's nothing that you can actually tell immediately from looking at it. So that's definitely a bad Kombat League skin. Like, I would not grind to get that skin. Some of these skins I would grind to get, no questions asked. But this one, even if I was a Scorpion main, no way, man. And little side note, if you guys are wondering who I main, because I do play Mortal Kombat, well, I used to play Mortal Kombat a lot, I'm playing other games at the moment, but my mains, Melina, definitely. I play Melina so much. I didn't really have any other mains. I enjoyed playing Liu Kang and Shiva. So my mains were probably Melina, Liu Kang, and Shiva. They're probably my mains, just if you're wondering. Sucks though, because there's no Shiva or Melina skins here. God damn it. Okay, our next one here is Scarlet, and her skin is basically the same kind of deal. It doesn't really give anything different. I'm not sure if it came with the... No, I think this hair, the hair's always been like that. The skin itself, not very interesting. It's just like with Scorpion, it just feels like a recolor, so I'm just going to put it in bad as well. I think because this was season one of Combat League, they didn't really put the effort into it because they don't look that different. Like even Aaron Black and Katanas, which are slightly different, they don't look like really, really different. They're just kind of, okay, you added something there, you changed that color. They're not actually like a whole new skin. So yeah, Scarlet's bad. Aaron Black, I kind of like it actually. I think the vest or whatever you want to call the vest thing that he's wearing, I think that looks really nice. I don't know why, but I feel like this is automatically better than the other two. It's not amazing because it's not like really different. So I'm going to put an okay. Because it is okay, the colors kind of suit him. I think he's more of a like a dark brown, black, gray sort of character. I don't think he's a really like this like pop red, because this red pops a lot. So I don't really think that's him. I think he's more a darker and more deafened or mute. I can't remember the exact word for it, but more deafened colors. And then there's Katanas, and I do like Katanas, but is nothing different. Literally nothing different. I thought that the skull was different, but it's not, because she has the skull there. It's just her Revenant skin. It is a little bit of her Revenant skin mixed with some of her other costumes. Meh. Though, it's got a cool face mask. That's what I really like. The face mask is really cool. I think I'm going to be slightly biased here. Just ever so slightly biased and put her in okay. I think that I think that skin is really cool. And now we are on to the Season of Time. This is Season 2, Season of Time. We've got Collector, Raiden, Jackie, and Aaron Black here. And all of them are, you know, okay. I think overall it's probably a little bit better than the Season of Blood, because they've got the eye effects, and that's new for all of them. And that is cool, man, especially Aaron Black. Aaron Black's costume, might as well start talking about it now, is pretty nice. I really like the white hat. I think that's cool. And the glowing eyes, that's even cooler. I just think it's a shame that it doesn't actually look that different. I mean, the armor looks kind of cool, but overall, it's kind of like, it's not that different. They're kind of relying on the fact that he has glowing eyes to, you know, make it that different. So even though I personally like it, it's a bad Combat League skin, man. I think Combat League skins in general weren't really good until you get to like this season here or this season here, you know, where they actually start changing things up. Because this one is not that good, man. Because when you compare them, because like all of them are cool suits, all of them are cool skins, but it's when you compare them to the other ones, it's like that's not different, that's not anything we haven't seen before, that's just a recolor. You already have these skins that you can grind for just a short time to get, and then you grind ages in Combat League to get these ones. It's like there's not much different, man. It's just the colors. So yeah, that's the kind of reasoning I'm going off, because the Serum Black one, though it's cool, not that different. The glowing eyes, yeah, they're cool, but that's the only difference. Okay, Jackie's skin, pretty much like Aaron Black, I gotta be completely honest. It looks okay. She already has armor, so it's not giving her anything different, really. And the eyes, though they look cool, they aren't really anything special. So I gotta put it in bad as well. I'm sorry, guys. You guys are probably hating me for this, but I've got to do this, man. I've only got 1, 2, 3. I've only got 6 tiers to deal with here. I can't be putting stuff like this in an okay tier, because there's some awesome ones here. And I can't be, like, comparing them to all this stuff, because this stuff's shit compared to some of these stuff. Okay, anyway, Raiden, I think in some of the skins, he's already kind of got glowing eyes. So I'm sorry, man. I'm going to put it in bad. I thought this season was going to be better. I truly did. But not really looking like it. However, Collector's skin is cool. This is a cool Collector skin. People trash Collector, say he's got shitty skins. He's got okay skins. Not as good as other characters, but he does have some pretty cool skins. And so this one here, which I'm looking at now on my biggest screen over here, is pretty cool, man. It is pretty cool. I like the helmet. I know lots of people don't like the helmet, but I like the helmet. I think it's a good skin. With the glowing eyes and the helmet, and like the jewels in the helmet like look a bit like the eyes, and it changes up a little bit, makes it look real cool. The armor covering his chest and his shoulders, good skin. Not awesome skin, but a good skin. Next, we got Revenants Reborn, and this is where it starts getting good, because this is cool. This is what everyone wanted when Mortal Kombat came out, man. This is what everyone wanted, because those Revenant skins are so cool, but no one wants to play with Revenant skins. No one. If you want to play with Revenant skins, you messed up, man. No one wants to play with Revenant skins. And now we finally got the Revenant suits on the human skins, and they just look awesome. So these are going to get high up. I know it kind of goes against what I said about how they're not any different from the other skins, but this is something that all of us really wanted when the game came out. Like, we all wanted to be able to use these skins just in the human form. So it was NetherRealm just giving us what we wanted effectively, because they didn't put it in the base game. So first we got Katana. Awesome costume. I love the headpiece. It's not awesome. I think it's good, because it is a really cool skin, and the armor effect is really cool. I think Katana with like the armored sort of helmet and body piece and stuff, I think it looks cool. I think Katana would wear armor sort of like this, so that goes in good. Jade's, I don't think it's as good as the others. I don't think Jade would wear armor, because she's a bit more of an agile fighter than, say, Katana is. I mean, obviously, they're both agile fighters. Everyone in Mortal Kombat are agile fighters. But I feel like Katana is just a little bit more like stand still and fight than like Jade is. Jade's flipping over all over the place and throwing her things and jumping and stuff. And I don't think the armor really suits her. I think I'm going to put it in okay. It's obviously not a bad skin. It's still a good skin. I don't think it's as good as Katana. It doesn't make quite as much sense as these other ones. Kung Lao. And Kung Lao's Revenant suit is alright. It's okay. I mean, it's a bit like Liu Kang's, you know. It's okay. It's not his best, really. But it is a pretty cool suit. You know, I do actually really like it, because it's like a battle suit, like I said with Katana. I genuinely like this suit. I think it's good. I'm not sure what I want to give it, though. I think I'm going to give it awesome. I might be being like just a tiny bit biased here, but I do actually really like it. I think it just has, it's simple, but it just has this armored effect that just makes Kung Lao just look like a bit more of a badass. I think it's nice. And I'm going to put Liu Kang, I'm going to put him in the same tier as well, because it is a good armored suit. These are like their formal battle wear, you know? I love it when games make formal battle wear and stuff for characters, because then it just feels more authentic. Like, they're no longer on the street. They're no longer fighting, like, people like Johnny Cage or shit like that. No, they are fighting whole armies of, like, interdimensional bad guys with swords and shit. So they got to be armored for it. And they, you know, got to have that movability as well, which those suits give them. So I think it's awesome. And that brings us to the fourth season. Yep, the fourth season, Chaos. It's these four here, and they kind of go back to what Blood and Time were like, just kind of recolors, really. Noob Cybot's one is pretty cool. It has a kind of cool color scheme, but I don't think the black and the orange really work together for him. If you're going to do black and orange, I feel like you'd need more orange, because in this suit, there's not much orange at all. I don't think it's horrible. It's bad, though. It's nowhere as good as these ones. It's pretty bad, man. I'm kind of sad how many of these Combat League skins have been bad so far. But, you know, NetherRealm's just recoloring stuff, so it's their fault. Next one, Sub-Zero. I like the headpiece. I think the eyes look really cool. I really like this one. Even though the suit itself, well, the skin itself, actually doesn't look like anything different, and I could easily put it in bad alongside Noob Saibot. When you actually think about it, the lore behind it makes it really cool, because this could easily be, I forgot his name. This is embarrassing. I forgot his name. But, like, if you're playing Sub-Zero with this skin, you could easily be pretending that Bi-Han. You could easily be pretending that you're Bi-Han as the first Sub-Zero, and that is awesome. It's allowing you to play Bi-Han, the first Sub-Zero, and so that is cool. And for that, I'm going to give it, well, not good, I'm going to give it an okay because of that. Because it is like the death sort of Sub-Zero, that's cool. Because he doesn't have a Revenant skin in the base game, well, in the game in general, I think. So that is really cool. I actually like that. Next is Cassie Cage, and I think I'm gonna put that in horrible. That's not that different at all. That is really shitty, man. To be completely honest, that's not a good suit. That's horrible. As is Frost's. The color scheme for Frost just does not work here. She doesn't wear those colors. That's just not right. So overall, that season was pretty average, man. So hopefully the next one's better. Here we go. Season. Pardon? Yo, is this one out of order? No, don't do that. It's gonna be so annoying. Oh my god, it is. Okay, I'm so sorry, guys, but this is out of order. That actually hurts me so much. That hurts me a lot. This one's out of order. So that was season four, guys. This is season nine. They did it to us. They tricked us. I thought this was perfectly in order. Obviously, it's not. We should just. Yeah. For the sake of this video, and for the sake of my OCD, I'm not gonna rank this yet. I'm gonna rank this as the ninth season. So we've gotta go to the real season five, which is Sorcery. These ones here, season five. These are cool suits, man. These are cool skins. This is when it starts getting good. Okay, so this Kano one, I like it. Looks like Quan Chi, which is really cool because I would have really liked Quan Chi being in Mortal Kombat 11. I think having Quan Chi would have just the roster a little, just that little bit more diverse. Because I think for this one, we had too many fighters that were just hand on hand, especially the guest fighters like the Terminator and stuff. There wasn't as much sorcery and magic as there were in Mortal Kombat 10, in my opinion. Like with people like Jackie and Jax and Cassie and Sonya and Johnny. There wasn't much magic, really. So I think having Quan Chi would have really mixed it up a little bit. Anyhow, this Kano skin looks a lot like Quan Chi, which is really cool. Even though Kano plays like shit and he's a shit character, it's an okay skin. I'd never use him, though. The skin doesn't make me want to use Kano. It isn't actually that different from his other costumes. It's just given him a purple eye, a little symbol on his forehead, and that's kind of it. I'm gonna put it in bad. Okay, this Cabal one looks gnarly, man. It is a gnarly Cabal skin. The face mask, nice, nice, pretty cool skin. Isn't all that different, but I think that the color scheme works well with Cabal, does he have a Revenant skin? I think yeah, he's got a Revenant skin, but this just feels more like authentic Cabal, like Cabal with gray skin. That's cool. I like Cabal with gray skin. Cabal with just like burn skin, just looking like a normal dude. Nah. Cabal with gray skin, that's cool. And having that face mask is really cool. Not a good costume, not a good skin, but it's okay. So I'm gonna put it in okay. Next one is Cetrion's. Bro, Cetrion literally has the best skins in this game, so I'm sorry if I put this one at best, which I probably am going to. I can't remember if it's all that different from other skins, but it is fucking awesome, man. This skin is so cool. It's almost as cool as like her Cleopatra skin, man. Cetrion has literally the best skins in the game, so that is definitely going in best. I think we can all agree on that, because it is an awesome skin, dude. Like, Netherrealm pulled out all the awesomeness for this one. Then there is Baraka's. He looking like Quan Chi as well. And Baraka's a lot more fun to play. Better character. So I'll probably put it in okay. Doesn't change all that much. But the eye makeup that goes up has way more of an effect on Baraka than it does on Kano, in my opinion. Because Kano's technically only got one eye. So you only see like half of it, really. But then you see it on Baraka and it stands out way more than it does on Kano. And it just looks really cool. Baraka with grey skin, awesome as well. You know, even though nothing much is different and it is really just like a recolor, I am actually going to give it good. Because I do really enjoy that one. Season 6, Conquest with Kotal, Collector, Garrus, and Devora. So the first one here is Kotal. Cool skin. Cool colors. I really like the colors. The colors suit Kotal. Not sure where I'd put it though, because, you know, It's just a recolor. It looks cool, so I will give it okay because the color scheme works perfectly with Kotal. Otherwise, I would be giving it a bad because it's just a recolor. Next one is Collector. Face mask isn't doing you any positives, buddy. It's not good. It doesn't look good. I feel like color scheme isn't really Collector. I'm going to put it in bad. I don't really feel like that's Collector, really. Garrus skins are pretty shitty, man. Like, even the Frankenstein one's kind of average. And Garrus, in my opinion, isn't the funnest character to play. So this skin would definitely not make me play it. Average skin. Garrus looks a lot better in white with this, like, normal skin, I guess. So I'm going to put this in bad because it's technically just a recolor. Okay, Devorah's skin, literally just a recolor. I mean, it looks cool, but when you compare it to the one you start with, yeah, I'm going to put that in horrible. There's so much you can do with Devorah, and like we see here, is it this one? No. Yeah, this one. This one here, this suit here. Freaking awesome, man. But like this one, there's so much you can do with Devorah. They obviously did not do all the cool stuff you could do with a Devorah. Next season is Death, and they're bringing in Revenant skins for Jax, Sonya, Johnny, and Cassie. And who the fuck wants to play with freaking Revenant skins, bro? I'm sorry. I'm putting them in horrible. I can't. Why would you make more Revenant skins? No one likes the Revenant skins. The only Revenant skin that is like okay, slightly okay, is Nightwolf's. His Revenant skin looks alright, you know? I might play with the Revenant skin sometimes, but for everyone else, no. Why would you make more Revenant skins? It's so stupid, man. The next one is Naknadian Greed. I think that's how you say it. Naknadian. I don't know. I'm sorry. But these are some cool costumes, in my humble opinion. Sub-Zero one, where is it? This one, Sub-Zero one, doesn't really do much. Kind of a reskin. I'm going to put in horrible because it is just recolored, in my opinion. It's not that good. Anyway, we got Jade's. Very good skin. Well, the colors kind of suit her. It's probably not as good as I just said it was, but it's okay. I'm not sure if we had this skin before the Kombat League one came out. I think I'll put it in okay, because I do like Jade in like gold and white. She kind of does suit it. She's probably the, out of all the ninjas in Mortal Kombat, she's probably the person that suits it the most, maybe like alongside Scorpion, a gold and white combo. I don't think Sub-Zero suits it. That's why, one of the reasons I put it in horrible. But she looks alright in it. Noob Saibot? Nah. Sorry, man. It's not horrible, but it's not good either. It's pretty bad. If it's not black, Noob Saibot just doesn't look good in it. Really? That's the kind of the bottom line with Noob Saibot. If it isn't just like, literally just all black, it's like, is that really Noob Saibot? And the other one is Shao Kahn. Looking pretty nice, actually. That is cool Shao Kahn skin. I like it. It makes kind of sense for him to be wearing something like this. He wouldn't wear full body armor, which, you know, this one makes him wear full body armor. He would wear stuff like this. He wants to show off. He shows off, man. He's a shower. He shows off. He does all that stuff. And then he tells you that you suck because you don't look like him. That's what Shao Kahn does. So I'm going to put an awesome. It's definitely not best tier. I honestly don't know what other costumes are going to be going in best tier. Yeah, but it's pretty awesome. Okay, now we're into season 9, which is all the soul ones. So here, we've got these. I'm probably going to be slightly biased for these ones too, because I really like the white and green aesthetic. So even though it's a lot like the time season, where it's just given them bright eyes and recolored suits, I'm probably going to be a little bit biased towards this one because I really do actually like the color scheme. So first one, Kung Lao. Kung Lao looks all right. I don't think the aesthetic really suits him though. And it technically just a reskin of his Revenant. So I'm going to put in horrible. Honestly, I feel like any of these could kind of be in horrible as well. It's kind of hard to guess, really. It really comes down to personal preference between these two tiers. Anyway, the next one is Katana. She looks good in white and with the green sort of tint to it as well. I think that looks really cool because she's also like the good child, you know, like Sindel's bad, Melina's bad, Shao Kahn's bad. She's the only good one. So giving her like the white sort of aesthetic, make her look like a bit of an angel compared to her family and stuff, makes more sense. So I feel like the white actually kind of goes well with her character. So I'm gonna put it in okay. It's definitely not anything higher than okay because it is technically just a recolor as well. So we put it in okay. Raiden, it's okay. Yeah, I feel like it's okay. The green eyes, they're okay. I don't think the green in this is the one that suits him. The white, I think the white suits him, but the green, I don't think the green suits him as much. I'm gonna put it in okay. Cetrion. My god, Cetrion suits, man. Cetrion skin's awesome. This is a good skin. Cetrion can fit any color scheme as well. So even though everyone hates her, you gotta admit, she has got some awesome skin. Like, she'd destroy at a fashion show, for example, you know? It's not as awesome as her other one. Not by far. I probably will put it in good because her one uses the green in better ways than I think the other ones do. Like her green and her suit, well, her skin in that one just looks better than the other three. So she's definitely the best out of that season. She's nowhere near her other skin, but she is pretty good. Okay, season 10, Shadows. These are some cool suits, man. These are some cool skins. First one, we got Scarlet. This is cool skin. Changes up to her hairstyle as well, which she looks good in, and the blue eyes look awesome. And the suit, the runes on the suit, like the markings on the suit, they look awesome, man. Like, so cool. It is pretty cool. It's just a shame that the suit itself isn't actually changed that much. I think I'm gonna give it awesome. Yeah, I think that's good. I think I'm gonna give it awesome. See, now, guys. Now we're in all the suits that are actually really, really cool. So now we're going to be putting them in higher up tiers and stuff. So this is going to be getting awesome, man. Frost. Okay, best. That Frost suit is so cool. Why do people give a shit? It is so cool having the big armored sort of Frost and looking all like sort of robotic and stuff. Awesome. Truly awesome. It is a really, really cool skin, man. I look at it. Look at it in all its glory. Can you see it there? I'm wiggling my mouse, but you know, my mouse is probably hidden behind the picture. Anyway, it is good. Then we got Liu Kang's skin, and it's awesome, man. The clouds on his chest and the runes on his abs. Bro, it is so cool. I'm putting it in best. I just have to, man. The suits are so cool. Sub-Zero's is still good, you know, with the runes and the black aesthetic. I like it, man. Oh, wait, no, that's Scorpion. Yeah, that's Scorpion. Sorry, that's Scorpion. I really like that. Not as good as the others. I'm gonna put in awesome though, because that's pretty awesome. Okay, next, season 11, Order. So Jackie's suit in this, pretty cool. I do like it. I think it's pretty gnarly. The eyes in this one all kind of fit the characters, I think anyway. It's not awesome. It could be considered a bit of a recolor. I'm gonna put it in okay though. Oh, it could be in good actually. I think I'm gonna put it in good. I think that's a good suit. Devora's awesome, bro. It is awesome. It's not best, but it is really awesome. It's taking that bug look just another step further and making it, you know, gnarly. And the dreadlocks, dude, the dreadlocks suit her so well, man. It looks awesome. I usually play, well, I don't actually play Devora that much, but when I do, I usually play with the hood. But I do really like this skin. I don't think I ever got it though, so I've never actually played with it. Baraka's skin. Okay, I know that it's really basic. Like, it's technically just a reskin. Bottom line, it is a recolor, but it looks so cool. It looks so cool. and like making the spikes on the shoulders metal and stuff. Oh my god, that is so cool. So cool, man. I want to put it in best. Because that is like the definitive Baraka skin, really. God damn it, I want to put it in best. I don't know. I'm really not sure where to put him. I'll put him in awesome. I wanted to put him in best so bad, but I think I'm just gonna put him in awesome. And then there's Jax, and it's okay. I mean, it's the younger skin. Bleh. The older skin is so much better. Yeah, I'm gonna put him in bad. Sorry, Jax, but you know, it's not that cool. And the next season 12, the Osh Tech Army. This is awesome. All of these suits are really gnarly. And surprise, surprise, actually, Kano's is really good, man. Kano's suit looks gnarly as hell. So we've got Kano's here. Not sure where I want to put it. Obviously, I don't like Kano as a character, but that skin is really cool. It's really gnarly. I think I'm gonna put it in best because I do think that this is probably my favorite season overall. Because all the suits are real solid. Apart from maybe the Johnny Cage one. It's okay. But I think Kano deserves the best for that. Johnny Cage, it's okay. The Osh Tech ruins look really nice on his chest. I think the yellow works well with him. Not as good as Liu Kang's, which we'll talk about later. Well, in a couple minutes. But yeah, it's okay. I'm gonna put it in okay. Jade's is pretty awesome, man. It is pretty awesome. The neck piece she has looks real sort of Aztec, because you know the Osh Tech are basically Aztec. And that neck piece looks really cool. Otherwise, the costumes, you know, it's okay. I think I'm gonna put it in good because I think the neck piece is where all your attention goes to the neck piece, and that's what they were relying on to make it look like a really good suit. So, you know, they did that well, so I think it's a good suit. And then there's Liu Kang's. I'm gonna be slightly biased again, but Liu Kang's is freaking awesome, man. It is a really, really cool suit. I don't think I've got it. But that would be the Liu Kang suit that I would use all the time if I had it. Like, I'd use it more than I would like the Wind and Fire God, you know, when Raiden and Liu Kang merged together and they've got that awesome suit, skin, sorry. I'd use that way more. It is just so much cooler. And sorry for saying suit all the time. It's because I've just done two DC tier lists. It's like I'm saying suit way more than I should be. Anyhow, season 13, The Fallen Kingdom, has some okay suits. See, I'm just doing it again. Has some okay skins. Overall, it's not a really good season though. Garrus one is it's pretty horrible. It's nothing different really. So I'm sorry, Garrus, but you're going in horrible. Is that the second time he's gone in horrible? No, but I don't think he's gone any higher. Yeah, he's not gonna go any higher than bad, really. Katana's is really cool. And I think the armor is actually pretty awesome, but it's not that different from her other ones. It just adds a little bit extra armor with some more plating and stuff. I will give it okay, because it adds the extra armor and stuff. I'm pretty sure, correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure it adds extra armor, so I'll put it in okay. Sub-Zero's one. I'm sorry, it's horrible. Shao Kahn's. Even though I don't think that he'd go into combat with a full bodysuit of armor, he looks like an absolute tank in this. And it's freaking awesome, man. Tanky Shao Kahn. That's pretty cool. So I'll give it a good. Now, season 14, The Hive. I'm pretty sure this season is ranked as like the best by Mortal Kombat fans. This is considered the best season. I mean, these three here, I think they are all considered the best. It is considered the best because it is the best. This Scarlet skin is freaking amazing, man. It is so cool. It works perfectly with her being I can't remember the name of Devora's race or if she has a name for her race, but being one of those Devora-like things just fits so well with her, and Scarlet looks awesome as it. So yeah, Baraka also looks really cool as it. I think the Baraka skin is gnarly, and giving him the eyes above his eyes to make him look like a spider—that's some cool stuff. It's not as awesome as this one, so I'm gonna put it in good, but it's still a really cool skin. The Kotal one, see, I'm not a big fan of the Kotal one. It does make him look like a bit of a badass with the helmet bit coming down in the front, and then the little side pieces that look like they could like poke you, then the shoulder pads and stuff. It looks pretty cool. I don't think it's awesome, like personally for me, okay, but a little bit of bias here, but personally for me, I don't think it's awesome. I think it's just good. Then the Cabal one, I'm sorry, but I never liked the Cabal one. I thought it just did not suit. He just looked like kind of dicky. And the yellow for Cabal, nah. I know people love it, but I don't really, so I'm going to put it in horrible. And now season 15, the Saurian Rebirth. Lizard people, woo! This is because we couldn't have Reptile. Netherrealm gave us three people looking like Reptile, because Noob Saibot doesn't really look like Reptile. But we got some people looking like Reptile, which is awesome. Jade skin is pretty gnarly. Yeah, I think Jade skin is probably the second best there. It is looking pretty cool, man. Looking pretty cool. Just the scale effect on her, like, shoulders, and even on the mask, there's scale effect there. It looks really, really cool, actually. It looks like female Reptile. Or is it Chameleon? I can't remember exactly. But it looks like female Reptile. It looks good. So it'll be going in good. Then this here, this is Scorpion. It is, right? I'm not going mad, but I'm not sure if that's... I think I'm actually going mad. You know, that's... It's got to be put in best, because that is basically Reptile. That is Reptile right there. They just gave us Reptile in the form of a skin. He's not his own character, but he looks pretty gnarly. Now we've got Noob Saibot. Yet again, his skin isn't really anything different. However, if you look closely... I'm only doing this just now, but if you look closely and you see those eyes, bro, they look awesome hidden behind that mask. It just makes it so cool. Even though you would never see that when you're actually playing the game, those eyes, that effect there is just done so well. So I'd probably give it a bad if it didn't have the eyes, but because it has the eyes, I'm going to give it an okay. Because those eyes are just, they're just so good. And then the last of them, Kung Lao. Looking okay in his Reptile sort of get up. It's nothing awesome. The Reptile scale pattern does look kind of cool on him. But yet again, the suit isn't anything really different. I'm just going to put it in okay. No, I think I'll put it in good. Then the last season. Season 16. The season of lawlessness. Couple very good suits in it, man. This is... probably put up there with like top five seasons or something, because you know it's got some pretty cool suits, and the arm pieces on all of them, that metal arm pieces where they're all trying to be jacks, that's really cool. So they're probably all gonna get kind of high up here. Sindel's, the red and pinky color, I think there's a purple variation, I may be wrong, looks so cool. The colors on this one is just awesome. And the battle suit with the white eyes, and then you got the metal arms, and then the highlights of pink and purple and reddy sort of stuff. It's awesome. Definitely going in best. That is one of the most popular suits for obvious reasons, obviously. But it is overall a really, really cool suit. Then we got the Cassie Cage one, which I see get used a lot. I'm not a huge fan of it. It looks okay, you know. But it's got the metal arms, and that's awesome. I do like the eyes. I think the red eyes look really nice. And they're accompanied by the black, red, and white of the uniform, and then the metal arms is looking pretty gnarly. It looks like a super stylized special forces sort of agent stuff, which is obviously what they're going for. So I think I'll put it in good. Then Johnny Cage one, kind of the same thing. Though nothing's changed or specialized for him as much as it is for Cassie. So I think I'll put him one tier down, because it, like, there's nothing apart from his belt buckle that screams Johnny Cage about the thing. In the metal arms, they only go down to like halfway down his forearms, which sucks, man. You should have it at least go down to his wrist. And then the final skin of this video, which might be a long one, honestly. I don't know. I'm not even going to cheat to how long I've been recording for. I think it was like a while. But the last one here, which is another Sub-Zero one. And, I mean, currently all I'm looking at is the skull, so I should probably look at the suit. I don't think it really suits that effect. I mean, the colouring. I'm going to put it in okay there. And that is it, my kin. That is it. So, even though this was a little bit of a longer one, and I think I contradicted myself just a tiny bit here and there. But I think overall, I agree with these tiers. Yeah, I definitely agree with all the best ones. I agree all of those deserve to be in best. Might have changed a little bit around this area here. Maybe just a little bit. Overall, I agree with all my choices. Let me know down in the comments what you think and everything. And if you enjoyed, please like and please subscribe. Helps me grow this channel bigger and helps me know that you're enjoying my content. So I can make more for you guys. And especially if you got to this stage in the video and didn't just skip through and you actually watched through it all, please do consider subscribing. Help me out a lot. Make me feel real good. But yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye, my kid.